My name is Sunita Chen. I'm the program coordinator at Afritos Consumer Experts. Today, I'm reporting live at the office with Cheryl Cohen, our president. She is going to give us a progress report on the physical activity tracker research study she's involved with. And I will pass it on to Cheryl now.
Hi, Anita.
Hi, Cheryl. How are you today?
I'm excellent. The sun has come out. The fog has lifted, so the world is good.
Okay, Cheryl. I was wondering if you can give us a progress report on your activity level as of in comparison to the last time.
I would love to. So this is the third week in the study, and I have found it to be as enjoyable as week one. I'm finding out more and more about my physical activity as the study progresses. My sleep quality is still not very good. And I think it's interesting that I wouldn't have known about my sleep quality had I not participated in this study, which I think is one of the reasons people should do clinical trials or research studies such as this one on physical activity. So things have been going well. I think the most interesting thing about the study, or being a participant in the study, is it's really heightened my awareness around physical activity.
And
I now kind of get a sense at the end of every day where I would be. I try to play a bit of a game with myself before I log in my data from my little Fitbit wristband. I go to my Fitbit log and I take a guess at where I think I would be in my steps, and I pretty much know if I've hit my mark or not. So it's basically raised awareness about my own physical activity, and I'm just better able to gauge, even without the Fitbit bracelet, sort of what my activity level has been in a day.
Cheryl, I understand you're approaching the end of your study. This is your third week. Will you continue to wear the Fitbit after the study?
I think I will. It doesn't weigh anything. It's on your arm. It's not unattractive. You know, it's just like one of those, it's a black rubber bracelet, basically. And I think I will, because I'm still curious to see if, now that I'm not in the study and reporting my data to the study investigators, if in fact I'll continue on being as active as I have been during the study. Also, one of the nice things is it was a gift as being part of the study, and there's about $125 value. So, you know, I was given it. It's actually taught me something about my physical activity, and yeah, I think I will continue.
Do you think Fitbit and the other physical activity tracker you are using, Body Media, will change people's views on physical activities?
Definitely. It has mine, and I'll tell you how. One day I went and I was doing a lot of walking. I walk a lot every day with my dog, Molly. But one day last week I played tennis, and I used that. I thought, oh, well, I don't have enough time to do as much walking with my dog in order to accommodate my tennis game. And interestingly, when I looked at my Fitbit activity log, the level of exertion, physical activity for the tennis period of my day was quite a bit lower than the active walking period of my day in the morning with Molly. So I had this notion that running around a tennis court, even at a sort of a moderately high recreational level, was going to be more strenuous or burn more calories, or I'd take more steps than if I were just walking my dog. And that was completely the opposite, that my walks, my fairly brisk walks with my dog in my day is the highest level of activity that I enjoy. So yeah, in that way I learned a lot about how different physical activities cause you to exert more or less energy, and I kind of had it backwards.
Thank you, Cheryl, and I look forward to reporting back with you next week, and hopefully you can share with us the detailed summary of your study provided to you from the researchers.
I would be happy to. Thank you very much.
This is Anita Chen, the Joint Health Program Coordinator, signing up.